These are handheld portable ink printers that can print nearly any text, image, or design onto almost any surface and material. From paper, cardboard, wood, clothing, even skin, well, sorta. It's this new sort of gadget I've had a ton of fun playing with, and I'm excited to show you guys what it's all about. I'm Ben from AuthenTech, and today we're checking out these two handheld printers, and I'll show you how they work, which is pretty incredible technology, a comparison between the two, which one I found is better, which, spoiler alert, I like to stay efficient for you guys, the MBrush wins by leaps and bounds, and it's the cheaper option, which is very cool. The PrintPen has some great potential, but one major downfall. So let's jump in and I'll show you. First up, disclaimers, no sponsorship on this video, but huge thanks to Evebot for sending me their PrintPen, and huge thanks to geekbind.com for sending me the MBrush. As always, all the links will be down below. First, let's start with the pricing. The MBrush, which looks just like the PrintCube, I'm not sure if it's a rebranded model or something, it's currently priced at only 100 bucks on Geekbind. Plus, they're free shipping, though as a heads up, depending on your location, the shipping time might take a little while. The PrintPen, on the other hand, is $250, quite a bit more. As for ink cartridges, another win for the MBrush. The cartridge that it came with had this little sticker attached that said replaceable with 62XL. So when I looked those up on Amazon, the tri-color is going for around 40 bucks. And you heard that right, it's tri-color. So the MBrush can print in basically full color. They also say a single cartridge is good for around 415 full pages of printing. So that should last me a pretty long time. As for the PrintPen, well, they sell these proprietary designed cartridges for $60, which not only means it's more expensive, but we can't buy third-party replacements. And it's only single color right now, no full color printing, which is kind of stinky. They currently offer a skin-friendly navy blue, but they told me they are working on a non-removable ink, which could result in semi-permanent tattoos and such, which seems sort of cool, maybe like a henna tattoo. I'm not sure, but there's cool potential there. I really want tri-color permanent ink for this MBrush here so I can print on t-shirts, because as it currently is, it looks pretty cool, but it can wash away with just simple water. I see that the PrintCube sells these permanent ink cartridges that uses eco-solvent ink. This might even work on metal, glass, and plastic, but I've seen a lot of shipping delays and complaints from backers, so I'm not sure what's going on over there. Let me know if you have info or ideas on a water-resistant ink option for me. Let me know down in the comments. On to product design and what's in the box. Each are well packaged, both come with a user manual, and the MBrush includes these two paper ruler templates for multi-line alignment. And that's right, the MBrush can also print multiple lines of text or large-scale graphics and photos. Again, a very cool and fun option to play with. The PrintPen does not seem to support multi-line printing yet, but note the print head on the PrintPen is 26 millimeters in height, which is almost double that of the MBrush, which I believe is about 14.3 millimeters in height. As for width, while the MBrush wins again, in a single pass it can print up to around 10 feet or 3 meters, the PrintPen looks to be limited a little over 3 feet or 1 meter. Both are small and portable, and I actually like the ergonomics of the PrintPen better. It sort of feels like I'm holding a marker or a large pen in my hand, where the MBrush is of course a little bit more blocky and wide, but honestly not a big deal. Both are rechargeable via USB Type-C. MBrush has this convenient rubber brush built into the cover for cleaning the nozzle, though it seems to dry out easily, more on that in a second. The PrintPen uses a roller sensor while the MBrush uses an optical sensor. The PrintPen's roller sensor I found is actually a little bit better for rolling onto skin, since it can keep that print head hovering just slightly above the surface, and we can almost watch the ink shooting out of those microscopic nozzles. That's kind of amazing. The MBrush was harder to slide across while hovering above my skin, and it didn't seem like the ink could shoot out as crisp or clear. Now, I think this little plastic piece is meant to attach to the printer when sliding across your skin, might help prevent smudging, but I found it still to be a bit smudgy, so I bet maybe with some practice it might get easier. Next is probably the biggest deal in my book, and that's the usability of each printer. The PrintPen had great potential, but one major flaw. I connect to the pen via Wi-Fi on my phone while using their app. I spent hours and hours trying to connect to the Wi-Fi, and it'd constantly time out or say incorrect password, even though it was the correct default one. I tried my iPhone 11 Pro, iPad, Galaxy Note 10 Plus, Google Pixel, Xiaomi Mi 9, everything I could think of, and with some back and forth emails with the company, it turns out that the PrintPen has a known Wi-Fi issue. I think it's very easily interfered with other Wi-Fi signals, and it won't allow me to connect to the pen with a lot of those signals going on. Either way, I had to walk like 5 blocks south in my neighborhood away from all the houses, and then I was finally able to connect it to my phone. And now even today, the janky little trick I found that works in my home is that I pinch the pen between my legs to try to block out all the Wi-Fi interference. And then only once in a blue moon, I can actually get it connect to my phone for just a couple seconds to quick shoot over a text or image, and then it quickly disconnects. So that really stinks, but I gotta remain honest with you guys, and that's why I can't recommend the PrintPen today. I hope they're working on an updated model, because again, it has nice potential. In a breath of fresh air, well, the MBrush is miles ahead in terms of usability. Three major factors that I prefer. First, there is no app needed to download to your phone or computer. Instead, we connect directly to the MBrush's Wi-Fi hotspot. Default password the same, 12345678, and then scan the QR code on the base cover or enter the address of 192.yadayada in your browser, and then bam, their app is right there, running in the browser off the device itself. Another great feature I appreciate, I can either run this on my phone, tablet, or my computer via Wi-Fi or connected via the USB-C cable. And the design prints right there in the browser. I can even push over a new design, keep it connected, swipe across to print it, push over a new file, rinse and repeat. Another major win to the MBrush, I like their app design better. The PrintPen had nice potential being a simple single line editor, but I found it glitchy even with dealing simple graphics and photos, and their editor's kinda janky. Looking at the MBrush in comparison, it has a little steeper learning curve, I'd say, but once I finally understood how it worked, it's much faster and easier to whip up some text graphics or even photos, crop them in size, then duplicate the print lines over and over for the multi-line function. Just hit print, sends it over to the unit, then I can disconnect and sort of saved in the memory of the device. So I can print it over and over, turn the device off, then back on, and it remembers my last saved print. The PrintPen sadly does not work the same. After I turn it off and turn it back on, it does not allow me to reprint what I last pushed over. As for quality of the print, surprisingly, I have to give some points to the PrintPen as it almost created these more crispy looking text and graphics. And I'm not sure if it's because maybe it's single color only, or maybe the DPI is slightly lower on the MBrush cartridge that I received in its box, or maybe it's just because the PrintPen nozzle height is taller, creating these larger looking graphics, I'm not sure. The MBrush allowed me a lot more control though over density, brightness, and saturation, and we can dial it in just right for each print. I found it takes a bit more finessing around, but once I find good settings, it looks pretty sweet. And again, pretty major deal, but to have a tri-color inkjet over a single color opens up a lot more fun printing possibilities. There's plenty of device settings to tinker with on the MBrush, and I bet dialing these in could result in even better prints as well. One major negative I found on the MBrush.
Okay, so if I don't use it very often, it gets dried out. So as a quick test print, we hold that button. It'll give us three stripes and there's nothing. Even in the instructions, it says if nozzle is dry, please pour a little water on the table, remove the cartridge, and soak the nozzle in water for about a minute. Google set timer for 1 minute.
The best solution I found, even though they suggest soaking it in water, I didn't think that worked that well. Instead, maybe a wet paper towel, rubbing it and wiping it, getting those juices flowing again on the ink cartridge. Now, interestingly, the PrintPen has this stamp pad-like insert on its cap. Not sure if maybe that's doing a better job at preventing dryout, while the MBrush has this little rubber gasket thing, but maybe it doesn't work as well, I don't know. Another random guess of mine, but maybe the cartridge used here in the box was old or janky, and maybe a new, fresh, higher quality HP cartridge could work better, we'll see. So, who is this little gadget made for? Well, besides it being a fun tech toy for me to play with, if I can get that permanent ink to work, maybe I'll create my own custom AuthenTech shirts at home. That would be awesome. I could also see this being really fun for lots of different arts and crafts. It could be used for branding and advertising, labeling, shipping, barcodes and QR codes. If I had an Etsy shop, this thing could be a lot of fun to experiment with. Overall, I'm fascinated by this thermal inkjet technology and I'm excited to see where it goes. My dream gadget would allow multi-line printing without needing to lift the printer off the surface, allowing me to paint back and forth on the surface, and that optical sensor would know exactly where it's at. Now, I think I saw the PrintBrush XDR can possibly do this, but I couldn't get my hands on one to test, and it's priced at $300, which is pretty steep. Maybe a firmware update will unlock this feature on the MBrush. All links will be down below. Let me know of other clever uses you can think of in the comments, and until I see you next time, let's live authentic tech.